see, I think if we look out in the world, we can see humanizations of communities where people are able to come together and see each other for the human beings that we are, to understand who we are, and sort of a dissolving of what old nationalism means and old borders. And those are things that were created to divide people. And I think that we're seeing now movements where people are coming together, are sharing experiences. There's exploitation in the Americas, there's exploitation on the European continent, there's exploitation in Africa, there's exploitation in Southeast Asia. And people of the world, poor people, oppressed people, people who are expulsed from their homelands, those are the people that will rise, and they will create the new world. They will create the new social conditions that are coming forth in this new century. I think sometimes we give global capital and nation state systems too much credit. Their power rests because we give them that power. And at some point in time, that power is going through a transition period where we are going to be able to express that power with communities who are oppressed, communities who are landless. And that's when we will see the changing of societies, the changing, the creation of the new world, the creation where every man, woman, and child will have human dignity. And that is the essence of what we need to evolve as a human culture.